Tonight we're having Goose Island with Endless IPA. I had a buddy who came over. I told him to pick anything up from the store, and he picked this up. They had their urban wheat beer. It was good. And their Indian Pale Ale I thought was good too. So this is a pretty good brewery from Chicago. I think Anheuser-Busch owns it, but I don't really care. I just care about the taste. It's like 5% alcohol on this. Endless Ale. Endless IPA. Endless Ale. Endless IPA. It has the goose on it. And let's start it out. A lot of these taste the same and smell the same too. Yep, it has that same piney, citrusy smell to it. It has the brownish, it has some carbonation, but it has that brownish, kind of like a lager, but a little darker. It's American Pale Ale, I believe. I think it's American Pale Ale. I always compare them to, the one I always compare it to is the Sierra Nevada Pale Ale, the one that first came out, I think, a long time ago. Yeah, this is like drinking. It doesn't have a lot of hops, but it has a lot of balance, citrusy, grapefruit. Got some carbonation. It's a good tasting beer. A lot of these start tasting the same after a while. I think Sierra Nevada has a little more taste in this. But this doesn't lack in the taste, but Sierra Nevada has more depth to the taste. And Lagunitas, but this is a darn good beer. Again, this would be good with a meal. This is sessionable. Summer. I like to drink these in the summer. I don't drink them in the winter much. Grapefruit. Balanced by the malt. Kind of, again, citrusy, lemony, piney. The Indian Pale Ale is a little more bitter. This is not real bitter, but it balanced out well with the sweetness, the malt. I like more of a balanced beer, so I give this an A plus, not A minus, not A plus, A minus. I give it a 91. I would bring it up if it was like Sierra Nevada had a depth to it, and Lagunitas, which is good too. But again, a lot of these taste the same. A lot of these, again, after you drink a lot of IPAs, but this is good. If some IPAs I had to throw away because they have no balance in the malt. But if you're looking to, this is like a gateway beer for people because it's light. Drinks like a lager. It has a mouthfeel, light to medium. Not much carbonation. Has a head still on it. Very well gradients. You can tell the gradients are good in this because you can go off-putting to it. It's a nice, light, pale ale for the summer. I give it an 8-. What do you think? Goose Island Endless IPA. What do you think about it? If you had, I think it just first came out. My buddies grabbed it from the first aisle, he told me. So, what do you think? If you had it or you didn't have it, what's your thoughts on it? Again, I think a lot of these ales, pale ales, kind of taste the same after a while. Just like lagers and even pale lagers from Europe. But I don't know how much you paid, but I liked it. But I'm not very picky. So Goose Island Endless IPA, A-. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again. Bye.